Hello and welcome back to the Healthcare Uncomplicated YouTube channel. Today I have another magnificent guest in the episode for you, but before I go ahead, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you get this great content every week. And also acknowledge our channel partners. And today gives me great pleasure to introduce you to Raj Sangroula, is the Chief Digital Officer at Sibel Health. Raj, how are you?
Thank you, Joe. Nice to see you again, after some time. I'm great. Thank you, and thanks for the time to be here.
No, thanks for being in here with us. And I believe we have a very exciting topic for our audience. The topic is AI in wearables in the healthcare industry. And the first question that I have for you is, what's happening in the wearables industry?
Yeah, you know, that's a great question. I mean, right now, you know, it started with like Holter monitor and, you know, different kind of patches to do cardiovascular monitoring, you know, I would say like 20 years ago in the medtech area, right? But the development has been rapid. And right now we're seeing a lot of wearable development, especially, you know, fitness tracker kind of a watches all the way to various kind of biosensors that can be applied to various physiological points and collecting information, you know, not just like, okay, heart rate, respiratory rate, but a whole lot of new endpoints and digital endpoints supported by, you know, various algorithms. So a huge leap, I would say, compared to, you know, what it was like 15 years ago. And I see it will continue to accelerate on that innovation. And especially, you know, as with like AI and all kinds of other technological advancement, we're seeing wearables are going to be the future of healthcare monitoring.
Yeah, I do agree with you. Things really change and evolve. It's very different the environment that used to be like 10 years ago when the wearables were very basic. Now they more or less can track everything. And you mentioned the sensors and the advances in technology, which is great to see. You know, I'm an advocate of wearables. I try to follow the latest trends and everything else. So yeah, very exciting days ahead. I would like them to be a bit more embedded in the healthcare industry, but of course we have challenges with it. Moving on, what role is AI actually playing in shaping the future of wearables?
That's like, you know, that's a fascinating subject because, you know, I mean, right now, as you know, with the whole, like, you know, different language learning models and stuff, AI is a buzzword. But for many companies especially in the medtech area using wearables, we have been using AI for, you know, last like 8, 9, 10 years already, right? So as we make advancement when it comes to computing and processing power, you know, availability of publicly available health data to run our assumptions and, you know, clinically collected data to validate a certain algorithm, I see also a huge amount of acceleration on that field. And especially in our case, you know, Joao, what I can say is Sibel Health, we provide clinical endpoints to both the pharma companies as well as clinical places like hospitals and global health. We have the opportunity. What we see is that using AI, we will be able to provide care in situations and areas where it would be very difficult to provide in the past, right? So, you know, somebody, areas like, you know, where you didn't have such great healthcare access, even in the United States, like rural parts of the US, right? Where doctors and hospitals are not so easily available, you know, one can wear a small sensor on themselves and using technologies and AI, not only be able to monitor them remotely, but also creating a various sets of risk scores. So if the patient deteriorates, you know, obviously we'll be notified, but even before deterioration, looking at various other data points to see, okay, you know, do we need to be proactive and provide care to this individual, right? So it's going to, I think, like what's going to happen is healthcare will move to more proactive care, you know, when it comes to addressing the healthcare needs of the population.
Yeah, brilliant. Certainly. Yeah, I like that you mentioned that AI is actually playing a role in reaching places. And of course, the wearables play a crucial role in remote patient monitoring. And now we have this big push for home care. Things are evolving really fast. So, and even community care, home care. The pandemic also pushed these kind of forces us to push this agenda forward, bringing the awareness, of course, about digital technologies, but also the technologies that are available, wearables, of course, and remote patient monitoring in different settings. So, yeah, things are evolving really fast. Thank you for that fascinating insight. And the third and last question that I have for you is, what are the main barriers to deploying wearables in the healthcare industry?
Yeah, and, you know, I mean, when it comes to challenges, obviously, you know, like myself, you know, working in medtech, health tech, and many others, right, you know, a lot of, like, innovative medtech companies, the number one challenge is convincing, so, you know, the regulation side of things, right, convincing regulatory bodies, and it's, you know, justified why they're skeptical, right? I mean, you know, they need to protect the patients. That's their paramount kind of a concern. But I think kind of a creating a lot of evidence-based data to show to the regulatory bodies that this new technologies or the new innovation that is happening, it actually saves lives. It actually creates positive outcomes when it comes to patients' health. And but doing that, you know, we're working with like a various kind of a, you know, in many cases, like a fragmented kind of a structure within the, you know, administration in the US or in EU or even in Asia, right? Because the pace of, let's say, regulatory and compliance structure does not always like follow the pace of innovation on the science and technology side. So it's catching up game for the regulatory bodies even to understand, like, you know, like how are you really testing your AI model, right? Because, and that is very important, you know, one can say, oh, you know, I have this great AI that's gonna like do X, Y, and Z, identify, you know, diagnose these kind of diseases or create a risk score, but then the question is that AI model is only as good as the source of the data itself, right? And the test data that it has been trained under. So, and in case of like, you know, our health is affected by our genetics, our, you know, gender, our socioeconomic conditions, and various other factors. So one AI solution may not fit everybody. You know what I mean? So especially in the US where, you know, there's a great push around diversity and equity and all those kind of stuff to kind of cover every kind of area of the population when it comes to providing healthcare benefit. You know, it's very important that all of this AI and innovation addresses those needs, right? You know, in terms of gender, age, socioeconomic conditions, other backgrounds. Right. So that is always a challenge because on the political side, on the, you know, regulation side, they're looking for that. Right. Like they want a solution or they want a technology that works for everybody. And it has to have great evidence to show that it is effective for the whole population, not just a section of the population. Yeah. And we see that, you know, with new guidance coming from FDA around even pulse oximetry, you know, like making pulse oximeter that works for all skin colors, for example, you know, or like all sizes of the fingers. And, you know, so, and that's just an example, but basically we're looking at, you know, two areas of challenges. One is like regulation side. And then on the other side is like, you know, you can say, you know, either like on the hospital side or on the consumer side, adoption of this new technology, right? Gaining that trust and convincing people that these new solutions that are coming in that actually brings, you know, a whole lot of benefit, and it's actually it's cost savings even for hospitals, right? Being able to address something now, or being able to prevent a readmission, for a particular like illness or after surgery, or being able to address chronic diseases at home. So at the end of the day, it saves money for hospitals and the government or the insurance companies, and makes everybody's life easier. At the same time, brings a lot of benefit in terms of health to an individual.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, Raj. I really like that contrast that you make about innovation and regulation not moving at the same pace. That's very, very true. And you know, I've done a lot of work around wearables. You mentioned some really important barriers there, the fragmentation. Actually, a few years ago, I've done a study about the barriers on the devices. And one of the top was interoperability, because different systems, different sources of data, and also the wearables bring more complexity sometimes. But you mentioned also the reliability, the quality of the data. The AI is as good as the quality of the data that you feed into the system. So exactly. Some really important things. The other day, I was actually talking to a leader from Mayo Clinic, and he also mentioned validation. It's very important, because not a lot of people are talking about AI and wearables, but not actually many people are doing the work. You guys are doing things. I know that with your brand and the Sibel Health, and you have some really great devices. But is a lot of this is a funny dynamic, because there's so many things to consider, and the barriers are actually big, and there are challenges. All right, yeah. This is a fascinating conversation. We could talk for hours. We come to the end of the interview. With one issue, we could run around for certainly a long time.
I know. Yeah, it is so huge, the whole healthcare and wearable industry.
Yeah, I appreciate your insights, and thank you for being available and your great work at Sibel Health. I have one last item to ask you. I expect a short answer, which is related to the channel, which is, how can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
Integration, universal integration point, right? Data should be exchanged freely without any barrier to and from an authorized user.
Wow, that's really, really good. Actually, in the Netherlands, they have a new policy to exchange data between organizations. You are doing some really great work around the health data policy, which hopefully the rest of the world will follow suit.
Yeah, let's hope so.
Raj, thank you so much. Nice to see you again. And keep doing what you're doing. You're doing great work. And hopefully we meet in person soon.
Sounds good.
I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Check our channel partners. And of course, I'm going to post Raj's social media here, his LinkedIn. Connect with him. Ask him questions about AI and wearables. Anything else around the devices at Sibel Health, and I'll see you all next time.